welcome to our online children's church. Children, I'm so excited today because our teachers from the children's church are here with us. Now, why don't we welcome them in a very special way? Now, I'm going to ask them to introduce themselves so that you get to know who they are.
I'm Teacher Jabu. Hi, children.
Wow, welcome, Teacher Jabu.
And I'm Teacher Martina. You're very welcome to our online children's church.
And welcome, Teacher Martina. Today is very special because we have just concluded our series on serving God. And today we are going to learn a brand new value. Before we enter into that value, why don't we have Teacher Martina lead us in a word of prayer? Teacher Martina.
Okay, hands together, eyes closed. Lord, we thank you for this morning. We thank you for the service that we are going to have. We pray that even as we learn about a new value, that we'll be able to understand it, that we'll be able to do what we are taught today. And above all, Lord, we pray that you will guide us as your children. We love you and we bless you, for in Jesus' name we've prayed. Amen.
Thank you very much, Teacher Martina. Now, as I said, we are learning a brand new value. I hope you've learned so many things from the values we have been learning. Now, the value we are learning is called discernment.
I'm a new soul. I came to this strange world hoping I could learn a bit about how to give and take. But since I came here, felt the joy and the fear, finding myself making every possible mistake. I'm a new soul, I came to this strange world, hoping I could learn a bit about how to give and take. But since I came here, felt the joy I now feel, finding myself making every possible mistake.
Just like we heard from Teacher Laban that our new value is discernment. But we need to ask ourselves as children, what is discernment? What is this value that we are talking about? Well, discernment is making a wise choice and doing it. I'll repeat it again. Discernment is making a wise choice and doing it. You know, in life we get to face very many different things. We stay in different environments. When you go to school, it's a different environment. When you go to the market, it's a different environment. When you go anywhere, things are different. But we need to be able to tell what is good and what is bad, what is right and what is wrong. You make a choice and choose to do it, okay? So even as we learn our lesson point today, which is, I will wisely discern the kind of friends I keep. Repeat after me. I will wisely discern the kind of friends I keep. When you have friends at school, when you have friends at home, you need to be able to tell which ones are you going to keep or which ones you're going to say, I don't want to go with those ones. So we need to be able to tell which one are the right friends. And these ones are going to help me grow. These ones are going to help me study well even at school. So we need to be able to wisely tell who are the right friends.
Thank you, Teacher Martina. As we continue with our lesson on discernment, we have two brands of soda here. Two of them. One of them is Coke, the other is Pepsi. You don't know which is which. But our friend here, Jed, how are you?
I'm fine.
Yeah. Jed is going to help us to know which of these is Coke and which of them is Pepsi. And we call that discernment. Okay? Jed, when you look, can you tell us which of them is Pepsi and which one is Coke?
No.
What do you think? Which of them is Pepsi and which one is Coke?
I can't tell.
Uh-huh. They all look the same, okay? But now, Jed will go ahead and taste. Jed, do you want to taste?
Yes.
Okay, please. Taste the two of them. And the other one. Mm-hmm. So, Jed, now, do you want to tell us which of them is Pepsi and which one is Coke?
Yes.
Okay, please go ahead.
This one is Coke.
Mm-hmm. This is Coke.
And this is Pepsi.
And this is Pepsi. Why? Because he has tasted and now he knows. We call that discernment. Now, if he had got the wrong taste, he wouldn't know that is Coke. And if he had got also the wrong taste on the other side, he wouldn't know that is Pepsi. Okay? In the same way, we need to discern the kind of friends that we keep. When you're with people, when you're with them, at first they can look good on the outside, but when you really get to know them, you get to know the words they speak are ugly, nasty words. The things they do, terrible. So you need to discern the kind of friends you keep.
Oh, thank you very much, Teacher Jabu. Now, in that illustration, we saw how discernment is very important. Now, many times, as boys and girls, we tend to think that everyone around me is good, so I can trust them all. Now, this is not true, because not everyone around you is good and has good intentions for you. Now, there are some people with very bad intentions. They try to win your trust in them, and at the back of their minds they have bad things they would like to do to you. That is why discernment is very important, to be able to tell whether this person has a good intention for you or he has a bad intention for you. You need to be able to discern and know who you should talk to and believe. Now, at times you may meet somebody as you are walking to school and they are driving in a car. And probably they would roll down their window and call you, oh boy, oh you girl, come over here. I have something I would like to give you. And probably they may want to give you a lift, or they may want to give you a sweet or a gift. But at the back of their minds, they want to kidnap you. Now, discernment will help you be able to tell that, no, I should not enter into that car. No, I should not talk to that stranger. Now, if your parents have told you, do not talk to strangers, listen to your parents, because they are wisely discerning and knowing that maybe those strangers do not have the best intention for you. Now, discernment is making a wise choice and doing it. In life, we need to be able to discern through the different things that we may face. And discernment helps us know what is right and what is wrong. Now, the Bible tells us in the book of Hebrews, chapter 5 and verse 14, and this is what it says. But solid food is for the mature, who by constant use have trained themselves to distinguish good from evil. Meaning that it's only the mature who are able to tell that this is good and this is bad. And in our value that we are learning discernment, we are learning how to tell that this is good and this is bad. So that when we are faced with these different situations, we are able to detect and tell, oh, this person has a good intention for me, I will listen to them. This person does not have a good intention for me, I will not listen to them. That's why we are learning, I will wisely discern the friends that I keep.
Hey, just like we've heard from Teacher Laban, that we need to be able to discern who are the good friends and who are the bad friends. And he gave very many examples of how you may meet someone and maybe they want to do something. It can be either good or bad. So I need us to learn something today. How can we choose the good friends? How can discernment help us to choose the right friends? We need to be able to learn that. How does discernment help us choose the good friends, and how can we choose the good friends? So I need us to talk about a few characteristics of the good friends and the characteristics of the bad friends, the ones we think are not good. Okay, so as we go to school, as we go to the supermarket, as we go to mom's workplace, as we go maybe to the shop, or on our way back to school, even as we are at home, there are those friends that you have in the neighborhood. But we need to be able to tell how to choose the good ones. So we can be able to tell the good ones how? By looking at how they behave. How do they behave? If a good friend of yours tells you, oh, do you know what? Let us go and play together. And if the games they are playing are okay, maybe you're carrying babies or you're eating food, those are good friends. But if there's a friend who is telling you, ah, let's go and play in mommy's bedroom, and then maybe you go, maybe they're playing bad touches and what, those are bad friends, okay? Then if it is a good friend and maybe you're going together to the shop, and this friend of yours tells you, you know what? Do not walk in the middle of the road. That's a very good friend. But if there's a friend who tells you, do you know what? Let's go and play in the middle of the road. And then as a car is coming, and then it might knock you. Those are bad friends, okay? So we need to be able to tell the good friends and the bad friends. And then at times, our parents who are older than us, just like we've had a scripture that solid food is for the mature. Even our parents are mature. They can be able to tell us who the good friends are. If your mommy hears a friend of yours saying something bad, like a bad word, your mommy will tell you that's not a good friend, and you need to be able to discern and tell, hey, that's not a good friend. But if your mommy hears a friend of yours saying, ah, did you go to church yesterday? Then your mommy will tell you, oh, that is a very good friend that you need to keep. Or if your friend tells you, did you do your homework? Then mommy will say, oh, that's a good friend that you need to keep. But if it's this friend who's telling you, ah, me, I don't do homework, then mommy will still tell you, or daddy, that that is a very bad friend. So as we learn from our Bible lesson today, we need to be able to tell how the good friends are good for us, yes, and how we can continue making them our good friends, and how we should do away with our bad friends. So we are going in for our Bible lesson.
B-I-B-L-E, yes, that's the word for me. I stand alone on the word of God, the B-I-B-L-E. I stand alone on the word of God, the B-I-B-L-E. Bible!
Thank you, Teacher Martina. And now it's time for Bible story. Children, our story is from the book of Luke, chapter 5, from verse 17 to verse 35.
The miracle of mercy. Jesus heals. This is Jesus.
Ohio.
Who is the Son of God and the Savior of the world. Jesus did many amazing things. He taught everyone about God's love, healed people from their sickness, and even calmed storms. The news of Jesus had spread all around, and many people wanted to come and see what he was doing. No matter where Jesus went, great crowds of people would follow him. Jesus went to his own town, and news spread that he was back home.
Ow!
Soon, the house where he was staying was packed. So Jesus began to preach God's word to the people. Meanwhile, some men heard that Jesus was in town. So they decided to take their paralyzed friend to him to be healed, for their friend wasn't able to walk.
Excuse me.
Huh?
But when they got to the house, they couldn't reach Jesus because of the crowd.
Oh, well.
No!
So they went to the roof and dug a hole right above Jesus.
We got this.
Then they lowered their friend down into the crowd right in front of Jesus.
Hey, everybody, how's it going?
Jesus saw their faith, so he said, "Son, your sins are forgiven." There were some Pharisees and teachers of religious law in the room, though, and they were horrified that Jesus would say such a thing. They said to themselves, "Who does he think he is? Only God can forgive sins." Jesus knew what they were thinking, so he asked them, "Why do you question this? Is it easier to say to this man, 'Your sins are forgiven,' or 'Stand up, pick up your mat, and walk?"
What?
Jesus went on to say that he would prove to them that he was allowed to forgive sins.
Yeah, right.
And so Jesus said to the paralyzed man, "Stand up, pick up your mat, and go home."
Okay.
So the paralyzed man stood up and picked up his mat. The entire room was stunned as the man walked out through the crowd. All were amazed and praised God, saying, "We've never seen anything like this before." And they believed that God had sent Jesus with the authority to forgive sins and the ability to help the hurting.
Wow, that was a wonderful story about the friends who were able to take their friend to Jesus to be healed. Now, there are so many things we can learn from this story about the kind of friends we have. Now, the men who took this man over to Jesus were probably his friends. Now think about it. What if his friends had not, were not able to take him to Jesus? Would the man have been healed? If the man hadn't wisely chosen his friends, would those friends have taken him over to Jesus and would he have been healed? Now, so we are learning that we should wisely discern the kinds of friends that we keep. So what kind of friends do you have? Do you have friends that build you up or you have friends that destroy you? So this week we are asking you to determine to choose the right kind of friends. Just as teacher Martina has given us different characteristics of the kind of friends we need to have, make sure you have the right friends that are surrounding you. Friends who are just like these other friends who helped this man be able to be healed. Amen. So children, will you have the rightful friends? Yes, I hope you will have the rightful friends. Now, let us close our service with a word of prayer. When I say hands together, you say eyes closed. Hands together. Father, in the name of Jesus, thank you for what we have learned in our lesson today. We pray that as we have the right friends, your spirit will help us discern on the kind of friends that we have. In Jesus' name, amen. Wow, that was a wonderful lesson. So what did you learn in this lesson, Martina?
I was able to learn that I should make the good friends because they will help me when I grow up.
Wow, that is a very nice lesson. Teacher Jabu, what did you learn in today's lesson?
To be careful not to just go with anyone who parks by and calls me, hey, come to my car. Mm-mm.
Wow, so boys and girls, I hope you've learned something special this week. So until next week, bye.
Let justice fill this nation. Have mercy, Jesus, please forgive us.
Eyes closed. Dear Lord, I thank you for my country, my president, and everything is good you did for us. In Uganda. And please, God, I thank you for my president, Mr. Kakoda Museveni. I thank you for what you've done for him. What you've done for him is good. In Jesus' name, amen.
Mr. Kakoda, I'm thankful for your friends you're giving us. I'm thankful for making our nation beautiful. And please bless those people who are sick. And please heal those people who are sick and protect my masses in Kenya and Rampa. And that thing in his head, please heal it.
Eyes closed.
Oh Lord, I ask you to protect Uganda, protect the president of Uganda, protect his ministers, protect us from this horrible disease, coronavirus. As you can, so that they can get the virus very quickly and give Uganda good climate in the name of Jesus Christ, our very God. Amen.
Loud.
Oh, kind and Heavenly Father, we thank you for this today. Heavenly Father, help us from this horrible sickness. Heavenly Father, help us to be good children. Help us to be children who serve others. Heavenly Father, help us in everything that we have prayed. Amen.
May coronavirus go away from this country. We thank you for the gift of life. We thank you for our parents and teachers and all the people and our friends and the community. Thank you for everything you've done for us. Bless my masses in Kenya and thank you for the gift of life. And thank you for the gift of life. Thank you for everything you've done for us. And thank you for all you guys.
In Uganda, as it is in heaven.
the political leaders to take care of our country, and I pray that other countries are protected by the love of Jesus and peace, send your guides, the angels to guide us. And I pray that we don't get this disease which goes, it spreads very fast. And I hope we abide this one. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Thank you, beloved.
Father, we thank you for Uganda. We thank you that you protect King President Museveni. We pray for President Kaguta Museveni. And we pray for all of the leaders in this country. We thank you for the children in this country, the schools in this country. We pray for the lockdown to stop. We pray for the coronavirus to stop. We pray that you're protecting the people in this country so that we can be good, and protect us. You're mighty and powerful, in Jesus' name. Amen. Hi, Teacher Laban. Nice to see you. Thank you for teaching us. I just want to say thank you for teaching us these things of good values, what is serving God, and all of the things that you're teaching us. And the neighborhood, which is the neighborhood.